Hello everybody, I am Jarrett Ross, a GeneaVlogger, and on today's vlog, I will be talking about DNA Painter and the tools available on their website. DNA Painter is a really cool tool which allows you to visualize where specific pieces of your DNA are coming from in your ancestry. In order to use the DNA Painter tool, you have to have genetic matches where you already know how you are related to them. In other words, you have to know the most recent common ancestor with your genetic matches. The basic idea behind how this works is that if you have a genetic match, the shared DNA between you and your match was inherited from the most recent common ancestors that you both share. So if I do a DNA test and my first cousin does a DNA test, then the DNA that we share was inherited from our shared grandparents. And some of you may be wondering, what exactly does DNA Painter do in terms of helping you out in your genealogy research? Now, I've found that it helps out in a couple of ways, and mostly it's useful when you're looking at unknown parentage cases. One thing that you can do is you can actually start to triangulate specific pieces of your DNA to specific ancestors. That way, when you have a new match who matches you on that specific part of your chromosome, then you can have a good idea of what side they're going to be related through. One way that I also used DNA Painter was the opposite way of triangulation, by finding someone who fit into the parts of the DNA that hadn't yet been found. In one of my unknown parentage cases, I was working with the child of the adoptee as the adoptee had passed away. So the child had done a DNA test, and we had located her mother's mother, but we were still looking for her mother's biological father. So we were able to find all of the pieces of DNA that she matched with her mother's maternal relatives. And then we found strong genetic matches that didn't match either her paternal side or her mother's maternal side. So we believe that they came from her mother's paternal side. And to double check that, I looked at how those pieces fit into the DNA Painter. And they fit almost perfectly into the spots that were blank. Now, this is no proven technique, but one of the beauties about DNA Painter, just like almost all genetic genealogy, is that the citizen scientists are at the forefront of this research. And a lot of what's being done is just by people like me who are just kind of working through and seeing what's happening. Now, after a while of doing DNA research and finding genetic matches in all different branches of your tree, as you begin to plug them into the DNA Painter, you're going to see a mosaic of colors. And what I've found that's really cool in my own research is that I've been able to see how the different pieces came from certain parts of the ancestry. And as you get closer and closer in time, the pieces get bigger and bigger. A great example of this can be seen through my cousin's DNA Painter. I was lucky enough to have my mother and my maternal grandmother test. So the pink we see is what my cousin inherited from our grandmother. And the beige is what my cousin matches with my mother. So the beige pieces that aren't where the pink are, we know that that was inherited from my grandfather. And the blue bar that you see is actually a relative through my grandfather's side. This cousin descends from my grandfather's aunt. And the blue bar below that is another cousin who descends from my grandfather's other aunt. And we know that they share our second great-grandparents. And then when you get down to the green bar, that's a cousin that's one more distant away. Because this cousin is actually descending from our second great-grandmother's aunt. So while we know that the blue pieces are coming from our second great-grandparents, we can be even more confident and say that that green piece is coming specifically from our second great-grandmother. Now, DNA Painter has a couple other tools on their website which are really useful, especially in unknown parentage cases. First tool they have is the shared centimorgan tool. This one is really simple. All you do is you take the amount of shared centimorgans you have with someone and you plug them in, and it gives you a breakdown of the possible relationships and how likely they are. Now, the second tool on the DNA Painter website is called What Are the Odds? Now, this tool was actually introduced to me at the Advanced Genetic Genealogy course that I took a few weeks ago that was taught by C.C. Moore and Blaine Bettinger. But interestingly enough, this tool was so new that even CC hadn't used it, and so it was one of the students in the class who was giving the presentation on how it worked. Now, since then, I was actually able to use it successfully in one of my Search Angel cases. What Are the Odds is a tool where you can build a tree with multiple known matches from a specific family and figure out how likely certain positions within that tree are the correct position for the match that you're looking at. So in the case that I had used it, I had an adoptee who was looking for his birth father. And in looking at all of his matches, I was able to find a very strong match to a specific family. And when I looked further, I found a lot of different people descending from the children of a specific couple. So I then went on to What Are the Odds, and I began building a tree for this family. And as I got to the parts of the tree where he had these matches, I would put in the number of centimorgans that he shared with these matches. Once I then had all of them plugged in, I began to build separate branches in which I believed he may descend from. From there, you then start to choose different positions in the tree that are the hypothesis. Now, the hypothesis being the adoptee whose father I'm looking for. So I'm basically trying to hypothesize, where does he fit into this tree? He obviously fits into the tree because he matches a bunch of descendants from different children of the same couple. As you begin to plug in the different spots for the hypothesis, you're going to get a score in the top right corner of each hypothesis box. And that score is basically giving you an idea of what are the strongest possibilities for how this tester is related to the rest of that family. One of the interesting things that was presented when I first learned about this tool was that the best hypotheses are at least 20 times higher than the lower hypotheses. So if one hypothesis is 20 times higher than another hypothesis, that hypothesis is going to be much more likely. So in plugging in for this specific case, I set 18 different spots for the hypothesis. How all of these hypotheses worked out in this tree, I found that I had 4 with a score of 0. So there was absolutely no way that he could be related to all of these people in these ways and be in that position within the tree. Then there were a few hypotheses with a score ranging between 1 and 10, a few that were somewhere under 100, and then there were 4 that were well over 200. Now, one of the 4 hypotheses that was well over 200, I quickly ruled out, because if he was in this spot, his father would have had to have been in his 70s or 80s when he was born, and from what we knew, that was just impossible. But for these other 3, it gave us a really good idea because it showed us which child of this couple was most likely the ancestor of our adoptee. Now, in the end, I was actually able to figure out this case fairly quickly. And it turned out to be hypothesis 5 was where our adoptee sat in the tree. Now, this hypothesis wasn't the highest scoring hypothesis. So it really goes to show you that rule of the 20 times, where it really needs to be 20 times higher of a score for you to be really certain that that's going to be the most likely score. Now, this hypothesis 5 was our second highest ranking score, so it was up there, but it was still 13 points less. Now, as time goes on and more people get to play around with these different tools, there's going to be a lot of new techniques that come out of the woodwork, and there's going to be a lot of new pieces of information that we're going to learn about DNA and the inheritance of DNA. Thank you so much for checking out this video. If you enjoyed, please be sure to give it the thumbs up. You can also click right about here if you'd like to subscribe. It's completely free to do so. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at GeneaVlogger. I'm the GeneaVlogger. I'm out.